today we're here in Springfield, Massachusetts, at the corner of Sherman and Smith Streets. What's so important about this location is that one of the most important events in the entire history of sports took place right here, and why we're here today. A building stood at this location long gone. It was a YMCA facility, more like a YMCA college. And their main facility was here. And within that facility, there was a large gym. There was a teacher there named James Naismith, later Dr. James Naismith. But as a teacher, one of the important elements that he brought to the education of young men was the physical aspect, the health aspect of an educational process. And he had a problem. He wanted to find a way to have these young men play some sport indoors. Most of the sports that existed back then, and we're talking about 1891, were outdoor sports. So, in a moment of brilliance, Dr. James Naismith did something. He created a new sport, one of the most important sports in history. What he created in December of 1891 was the sport of basketball. And what is also unusual about that is it is probably the only significant sport in all of history that one single individual was responsible for creating at a specific time, at a specific place, and one name is attached. He wrote 13 rules for the game. The very first game was played on December 21st, 1891, on this site. And then a few months later, on March 11th, 1892, the first real official game of basketball was played here. It was a faculty versus students. Dr. Naismith played for the faculty, and the score of that first game of basketball was all of 5-1, with Dr. Naismith's team winning. So, what's important to us and the new sport, which is codenamed X-Ball, which we'll be introducing shortly, is that, like basketball, it's a created, specific sport, an original sport. And we owe a debt of gratitude to Dr. Naismith for what he did 120 years ago and what we are going to recreate in a different way 120 years later. Here we are now in Springfield and X-Ball created in New York City in Lower Manhattan. This is the actual building, an image of the building that stood on the site where basketball was invented and first played by James Naismith. This is Dr. James Naismith, an image of him, physical image of him, right here. And these are the steps of the building that stood here in 1891, a school that would become later Springfield College. I'm here on the campus of Springfield College. I'm sitting next to the official statue of one of the most important figures in the entire history of sports. This is Dr. James Naismith, the inventor of the sport of basketball. The statue is here on the campus of Springfield College because Dr. Naismith, back in the 1890s, was a teacher in Springfield and he was attached to the school, the YMCA-related school that was the precursor of, which became Springfield College. And Springfield College, of course, is very proud of the fact that the inventor of basketball is intimately associated with them. We filmed elsewhere, the actual place, the actual building where the school existed and the gymnasium in it where basketball was first played. This statue of Dr. Naismith on a bench with a peach basket here below him. The reason is when the sport was invented, what was utilized initially were peach baskets at both ends of the court. Basketball originally with the 13 rules was a game that was played with a soccer ball. Initially with a soccer ball, and the ball wasn't bounced, but the ball was carried by the players and thrown between them. So the game evolved a bit, but the basic sport as it was invented by Dr. Naismith is the same sport that is played today. It's unique in the entire history of sports in that, as opposed to virtually any other significant sport, it was invented by a specific person as a specific place, and we're relating it to what is still codenamed X-Ball because X-Ball is the only other sport, and we hope will be a notable sport, that was in the same way invented and one place at one time whole, as opposed to all the other sports. So, Dr. James Naismith, we are inspired by you and our new venture at New Sports Group, LLC, and we constantly mention Dr. Naismith and basketball because of its sort of conceptual relationship to the sport that we have created. And we thank him, and I'm proud and we're happy to be here today in Springfield, Massachusetts, late spring, early summer, here at the official statue of Dr. James Naismith, one of the great enduring figures in the entire history of sports. Basketball now being the second most popular sport on earth following soccer. Interestingly enough, also about basketball, within only a few years of its original invention in December of 1891, it was being played across the nation, and it was being played by both men and women. As a matter of fact, another very interesting aspect of the 13 rules that were originally written by Dr. Naismith himself, and those original documents still exist, is that he mentions a sport for both men and women. In the rules itself, he talks about men and women playing the sport of basketball, which is another very unusual element because none of the other sports have rules initially that specifically referred to both men and women. And the sport that we're developing, X-Ball, also has an important element that includes both men and women playing the sport. So, on to the future, and with appreciation for you, Dr. James Naismith.